one of the tenants I was saying, good morning. Hi, thank you. I mean, this could be a really big deal. This happens on there. Millions of people who have to work on call would love to see what happens here. In California, we're just about this victory from the appeals court saying that if you have to be on call 2 hours before you start, you can pay for those 2 hours. Even if they don't call you in, the judge said it wasn't fair to people who have to do things like call babysitters or arrange for a ride, and then they don't get paid. What about all the other people on that train there? Plus, in the meantime, they're taking other jobs. They're going to pay during that time. Illinois might become the next state to pay $15 an hour as its minimum wage. A state senate panel approved that idea that gives businesses about 6 years to gradually raise pay if this goes through from $8.25 an hour. Now, there's also a provision, by the way, so that they don't have to pay, let's say, teenagers for work for the summer or part-time after school. They don't have to pay them so much. And when you're creating a deep vacation, if it paid off your student loans, Ford said the student insurance, which is out of Tennessee, is doing just that. If you take a week's vacation, student will cut a check through your pay, bring to your student loan company, and it also works for parents that are paying for their kids to go to school as well. Interesting idea for a new perk if that stretches out. So what do you think? I was wondering, would you trade a week's pay for something like that, where you got a check cut straight to your student loan? It could be a dead rush payment. What is the advantage? Maybe if you never had it, you may not miss it. But a week's pay, that's a lot of minutes, isn't it?
A week's pay.